In this lecture, we'll talk about regular diode. We'll solve some problems in about regular diode and check their behavior in case we have only one diode in the circuit, two diodes, one voltage source or many voltage sources. These two diodes or two diodes are series or in parallel or a combination. In sheet 6 or the sheet that is related to regular diode will has many examples too. Okay, in this lecture, the first example in this lecture, if I have a diode and a resistor and this source is negative and this part is the positive. So the negative of the diode, negative of the battery is connected to the positive. So this diode is called in reverse. So it will be replaced by open circuit. So the current in this branch will be, the current in the circuit will equal to zero if this is the required item. Yeah. For the second question, we have a diode and a battery and a resistor in series together. The question is to get the value of the I diode and V out V at this point in this circuit. We can solve questions like this using two methods. We can apply KVL or use the rule that states that V out equal V in minus 0.7. فلت solve this question using one method. يعني the first method, first of all, as we can see, the negative part of the battery is connected to the negative part of the diode, so negative is connected to negative and this diode is called to be connected in forward. So we can make use of the rule that LV out equal VN minus 0.7. For this circuit, this point is the VN of the diode and this point is the V out of the diode. So we will replace LV out by minus 5 and replace VN in this equation by say V out minus 0.7. So minus 5 equal VO minus 0.7. The final value of V out is negative 4.3. To get the value of the current that pass through the diode, it will be the same as the current that pass through the resistor 2.2 kilo ohm. Since they are in series together, the current that pass through the diode pass in this direction as shown. So the current in 2.2 will pass in this direction 2. So it will be in this direction. To I diode equal I to I of 2.2 kilo ohm. If we'd like to get the value of this resistor, it will be V over R, which will be 0 minus Vn or V out over 2.2. We will يعني set 0 before V out, not in this direction but in this direction. So it will be in minus out Vn, ground minus VO over 2.2. So it will be 1.95 milliampere. As can be shown, the diode in the circuit allows the current to pass through the circuit and get a value greater than or equal greater than zero. This can be used in many in some applications such as switch in or switch off. To answer this question using the KVL, we can replace the battery here by we can replace this battery by negative 5 by a battery such as that we can close the circuit something like this. Okay, but the negative will be here and then the positive since we have negative 5. Okay. If we replace this value by this part of by this battery, so we can set only 5 here. Okay. If we would like to apply KVL, we can go through clockwise or anti-clockwise. We can go anti-clockwise to be in the same direction of the ID. The KVL equation will be, if we start by it at 2.2, it will be 2.2 multiplied by the ID plus 0.7 minus 5 equals 0. 2.2 ID, since the current that pass through this branch I, which will be the same as ID since they are in the same direction. Okay, we plus 0.7 since this is the positive part of the diode, so it will be plus 0.7, and this will be negative negative 5 since the current will enter this part, this device in the negative A part of it. So this will be the equation. Solving it, we will get the value of the ID to be 1.95 milliampere. To get the value of of the V node, I of I in the diode equals I in the 2.2. So the 1.59 milliampere equal the current that passes in this direction, which will be 0 minus VO over 2.2 kilo. V out will equal to negative 9.3. Okay, this is all for this question. So we can conclude that in we can find only one diode in the circuit. We can find a DC source. We can find that the current at the circuit is can be greater than or equal to zero if the diode is forward, and we can solve this question using two methods, making use of the rule V out equal Vm minus 0.7, or in using the KVL. We can solve another question. We have here positive 8, 1.2 kilo, V out, 4.7 kilo ohm diode are in series together. The question is to get the value of the ID and the V node. We can solve this using this rule at the first. We can check that in the positive of the battery is connected to the positive of the diode, so this diode is called to be connected in forward. So we make use of this rule, V out equal V in minus 0.7. V in of this diode is this point, and V out is this point. V out is 0, so 0 equal V in minus 0.7. This point is this point is V in. So Vn, according to the equation, Vn equal 0.7, this point will be 0.7, since it is the input of the diode. Okay, till the moment we couldn't get the value of the ID or the V out, so we can, to get the value of the V out, we can say that in the current in this branch equal to the current in this branch. So the current will be in this direction. The current that passes in this resistor will be in this direction, and the current that passes through this resistor is in this direction, and is in the diode will be in this direction. So to write this equation, we will say that T8 minus V out over 1.2 equal V out minus 0.7 over 4.7. So the final value of V out will be 6.5. To get the value of the current at the diode, we can say that in the current at the diode equal to the current at 4.7 resistor, since they are series together. So it will be V out minus the V out minus the V in over 4.7. So the final value of the current will be 1.23 milliampere. Okay. We can solve this question using another method, using the KVL. to apply the KVL in order to close this loop, we can do something like this. This is 8, so this will be the positive part of the battery, and this will be the negative part of the battery. And we will have here 8 volt. To apply to write the equation, we can assume that the current pass clockwise, since it is the same direction of the current at the diode, it will be also clockwise. Okay. So the equation will be negative 8 plus 1.2 ID plus 4.7 ID plus 0.7 equals 0. The final value of the I will be 1.23. To get the value of the V out, we can say that in the current at the diode equal to the current at 1.2 resistor, so it will be 8 minus V out over 1.2 layer resistor, so the V out will equal to 6.5 as the previous example. Okay, as the previous answer. Okay. Till the moment we find that the diode can be connected with a DC source, it can result in a current that is greater than or equal zero. It can be used as a switch on that allows the current to pass through the circuit. And we can solve any question using two methods. We can make use of the V out, the rule of the V out equal V in minus 0.7, or L using KVL. We have another question. We have two types of L diodes. We have two types of diodes, silicon and germanium. Both of them are regular diodes. We have a battery positive 20. We have a resistor R in series together. We would like to get the value of the V out and the value of ID, our current that pass through the diode. To solve this question using a rule of the V out equal V in minus 0.7, we have to check first if the diode is forward or not. The positive of the battery is connected to the positive of the silicon, so it will be forward. So the value of the V out equal V in minus 0.7. So this value will be 20 minus 0.7 equals 3 equal 90.3. Okay. If we set the same rule for this diode, the V out equal V in minus 0.3. So the V out will equal to 9.19. We can say that in the silicon has a voltage drop across it equals to 0.7, and germanium has a voltage drop across it equal 0.3. So if we'd like to decrease the voltage, the input voltage, we can decrease it by 0.3 for the germanium and 0.7 for the silicon. So the final value of the V out equal this value. To get the value of the ID, we can say that in the ID, our current that passed through the ID equals the same current that passed through the 2 kilo ohm, since they are in series. So it will be if it passes in this direction, so the current in 2 kilo ohm will be in this direction. So it will be 19 minus 0 over 2, it will be 9.5. Okay. To solve the same question using KVL, we can close the circuit by putting this positive is connected to the negative of the diode. Okay, and close the circuit something like this. Okay. So to create the KVL equation of this of this loop, we have negative 20 plus 0.7 plus 0.3 plus 2 كيلو ID equals to 0. Okay. Minus 20 since this current will be entering this part, it will be negative 10, negative 20 plus 0.7 plus 0.3 plus 2 multiplied by ID, or I that passed through the KVL. The final value of ID will be 9.3. To get the value of V out, we can say that the current that passes through the diode equal to the current that passes through the resistor, since they are series together. So I in the diode equal to 9.5, while I in the resistor equals to 9 minus 0 over 2. It will be till the moment in this question we don't have the V out till the moment. So solving this equation, we can find that the value of V out will be this. Okay. A conclusion of this circuit, we may have two diodes in circuit in series together. We can have different type of diodes in circuit. We can solve this question using any method, using V out equal V in minus 0.7 or using KVL. If we have circuit like this and would like to get the value of V out and V in, as can be shown, the positive of the battery is connected to the positive of the diode, so this diode is said to be forward, so the diode is on or forward. We can solve it using the rule of V out equal V in minus 0.7. So this point is V in and this point is V out. So as usual, in this example, we have 20 minus 0.7 equal 19.3. So we may have the input of the diode and get the value of V out. But in this example, we don't have the V in or we don't have the V out. So just we have a relation between the V out and the V in. V out equal V in minus 0.7. As a rule, the V out in this circuit is the V O, so the V O equal will V in equal V in minus 0.7, so the V out equal V in minus 0.7, or we can say that in the V out equal O V V in equal V out plus 0.7. Okay. Time. The second step is that we can say that to get the value of V out, we can say that the current that passed through the resistor 1.2 equals the current that passed through the resistor 4.7. Since they are series together, so the current is follows from this branch, this point to this point. Okay. So it will be 10 minus Vn over 1.2. Will current pass through this branch in this direction? So it will be V out minus minus 2 over 4.7. Okay, this will be the equation. Till the moment we have an equation with two variables, we can substitute one variable by another to solve the equation. We can replace any V in the equation to be V out plus 0.7. So V out V in will be V out plus 0.7. We can solve to get the value of V out, which will be 7.04 or something like this. 7.002. Okay. Type to get the value of the diode, the current in the diode. We can say that the current is load is the same as the current that is in the resistor 4.7 since they are series. ID equal the current in the 4.7 equal 7.002 minus 2 over 4.7. It will be 1.9 milliampere. Okay. To solve this question using this rule, this is the answer. We can solve this question again using KVL. to close the circuit we can have ال 10 we can replace 10 by voltage source something like this, the positive and the negative. Okay, and we can replace the negative to be something like this, the negative. So the negative is here and the positive is here, and then close the circuit, put 10 here and put 2 here. Okay, then we can apply KVL to be in the same branch as in the same direction as the ID. It will be clockwise. Okay. طيب the equation will be negative 10 negative 10 my plus 1.2 ID plus 4.7 4.7 ID minus 2 equals 0. Okay, then the final value of the ID will be 1.9. To get the value of V out, we make use of the relation that in the ID equal I at 4.7 since they are series together. So 1.9 equals 2. The current in this branch is V out minus 2 over 4.7. The V out equal to 7.002 volt. Okay. This is for this question. Okay. Till the moment we handles the case that the diode can have a DC source in the circuit. In some cases, we may have duplicate slide. We may have an AC source that is connected to the diode circuit. We have to practice some questions related to this type of questions. And here we find that we can have DC source, DC battery, DC battery, DC. Here, okay. Here we have two DC battery. Okay. What about if this diode, if this battery is AC? AC means that we have an input sine wave. We have an input sine wave to the diode circuit. The sine wave, the difference between the sine wave and the DC circuit is that it is alternating in time, which means that the diode can work as forward and reverse for the same circuit. Okay, if I have circuit like this, and this is the V input, and this is the V out. Okay, the question is, what will be the response of the this circuit at what will be the value of the V out of this circuit? If we have an input sine wave, we speak say 10 in positive and 10 in negative. To answer this question, we have to solve it into steps or two phases. The first phase is that what if LV input can greater than or equal zero, which means that in LV input is positive. If LV input is positive, then this value is positive and this value is positive, so the diode is forward. It's said to be forward in this A. Forward, I want to say, we can say it as on, okay? On or forward, okay? To get the value of LV out in this case, we can make use of a rule that states that in LV out equal LVN minus V out equal LVN minus 0.7. ال V out of the diode is ال VO وال V in of the diode is ال VI. ال VI minus 0.7. So the value of ال V out, the required value of ال V out in this part is said to be VI minus 0.7, which means that if you have a sine wave with the peak value of 10, it will be the same as V out V sine wave, but its peak will be minimized by 0.7, which will be 9.3. Okay. If you have a VI to be 1 at this point, so it will be 1.7, which will be 0.3. Okay. If we have 9, okay. We have 9.59 minus 0.7, it will be 8.3. Okay, so the same signal, the output signal will be the same as the input signal, but minimized by 0.7. What about the second phase or the second case, which is the I V input is less than 0, which means that the V input is negative. If the V input is negative, so this diode is connected to negative is connected to positive, so this diode will be open circuit. Okay. To get the value of the V out, for the case of having open circuit, this means that there is no current in the circuit, there is no alternating, or there is no difference between the voltage. So ال V out will equals to 0. V out will not equal ال V in, since ال V out is not connected to ال V in at all. It is an open circuit. So ال V out will equal to ال ground. ال V out equal to ال V ground is connected, is equals to the one that is connected to. ال V out is connected to ال ground. Okay. It will be the same value, since there is no current in the circuit. It's an open circuit. So the V out will equal to 0, so the result here is will be 0. Okay. This is the strategy by which we can solve the questions of having an AC signal. We can solve the circuit in two phases. If the V input greater than or equal to 0 or less than 0, we will have two different values. The diode in this circuit can work as two cases, forward and reverse at the same circuit. Okay. One of the possible now we can remove if we can replace the circuit, يعني we have we may have another circuit, we may have the diode, okay, but is it changed أو flipped يعني, okay, the resistor, the question is what will be the value of LV output. We have to solve this using two phases, and if V out, V in greater than or equal to 0 or V in element 0. طيب. For the case that in V out V input greater than or equal to 0, this means that it is positive. So positive here is connected to negative, so the diode is is reverse. So it will be off, reverse, off or reverse. Okay. So the diode is an open circuit in this branch, and we have V out is connected to the ground. The V out, and this is the resistor and the ground. The V out will equals to 0, since this is an open circuit. This is an open circuit, so there is no current, and there is no difference in voltages, So الفولت ال V out will equals to الجراوند أو will equal to zero. It cannot be equal to ال V input since there is an open circuit. It is not connected at all to the V in mainly. So ال V out will equal to zero. So it will be zero in this part. Okay. طيب for the case that إن ال V input and the V input is less than or equal to zero, this means that this is negative and this is negative. So we diode is said to be on or forward. الديود will be forward. So we can make use of a rule that in ال V out equal ال V in minus open 7. ال V out equal V in minus 0.7. ال V out of ال 0.7 here. ال V out of this diode is this point. So it will be VI equal ال V in which is this point we which is VO minus 0.7. So ال V out equals to V in plus 0.7. ال V out equal V in plus 0.7. Okay, so if you have a value of V input, you can add 0.7 to it. So the maximum peak here in negative part is negative 10. So negative 10 plus 0.7, it will be a 9.3. It will be 9.3. So this circuit is the inverse of the previous circuit. When the diode is flipped, the output is flipped. This is all for this case. We can have another examples of the diodes. Okay. We can have another circuit here. We may have a resistor and a diode. Okay. We can solve this circuit using the two phases. Okay. Where the V out is here. The difference between this point, this circuit, and the other circuit is that the resistor are swapped. The resistor and the diode are swapped together. Answer this circuit? How to answer this circuit? For the case that in the V out is greater than or equal zero, this means that the V in is positive. The positive is connected to the positive. Okay, so the diode is forward, or we can say that it is on. So we will use the rule that the V out equal V in minus 0.7. The V out equal ال V in minus 0.7. تمام. ال V out of this diode is the ground, so zero equal ال V in is ال V O, so ال V O minus 0.7. The final value of V out will equal to 0.7. This means that in V out equals to a constant value. In other words, it doesn't depend on V in. So the result will be 0.7, a static value 0.7. In this case, or in this behavior, we can say that the diode can works as being limiter. Limiter is that we can use in the charger of your mobile phone. If your home has a voltage of a specific value, and your telephone has accept a specific charge or a specific voltage value, you can use the diode to build a charger that accept only a specific value, convert the input to only specific value. So if you have 10, it will be only 0.7. Okay, this may be an application of a diode. For the case that in Vn is less than zero, this means that Vn equals to negative value. So a negative is connected to a positive, so the diode is reverse. Okay, so I will have only the resistor, and in this part of the circuit will be open circuit, and this will be a ground. Here 0.7. Open circuit, with this will be VO, where this is V input. According to this circuit, we have an open circuit, there is no current, there is no change in voltage, so LV out will equal to the one that is connected to directly. LV out is connected to LVN, not connected to L ground. Okay, not connected to L ground since it is an open circuit. So LV out will equal to what? To equal to LVN. LVN in this case usually is a negative value, so it will be the same circuit, the same sine wave, which has a maximum peak of 10. Okay, so since it is V out equal V in, the same value of V in. Okay, this will be the output of L diode for the sine wave and the positive value and the sine as a positive part and the negative part. We have another case of L diode. The sheet has many other examples, يعني, but we this example the diode is converted or swapped, flipped, يعني. We can solve this question using two cases, LVN greater than or equal to 0, LVN is less than L0. For LVN greater than or equal to 0, so L positive is connected to negative, so this diode is on. Okay, resistor on, open circuit, sorry, open circuit and the ground. Open circuit, so LV out equal to LVN. LV out will equal to LVN since there is no current and no change in voltage. LV out will equal to the value that is connected to it directly. LV out will be 10. Okay, this is for the positive part. For the negative part, the negative is connected to the negative, so the diode is forward in this case, so we can say that it's on, here is off. For the diode to be on, we can make use of the rule LV out equal LVN minus 0.7. Minus 0.7. So LV out of this diode is LVO. Well, VN of this diode is 0 minus 0.7. So LV out will equal to minus 0.7. LV out equal to minus 0.7. It will be a static value. Static value that doesn't depend at all on ال Vn. Okay, so it will be something like this. Okay, such that this value is 0.7 in negative. Okay. Okay. That's all for this lecture. I think we have another example here, another remaining example. Okay. Usually, يعني if the diode is on, we make use of the rule that is V out equal V in minus 0.7. This is a more general rule, يعني, or a specific special rule, يعني. A special circuit. If we have this sine wave and this circuit, what will be the output? What will be the output? Okay. For the positive, for the Vn to be positive, the positive is connected to the positive, so the diode is on. So the diode is forward. This means that in the diode has a voltage drop of 0.7 and the resistor will be have the same voltage since they are parallel together. So V out equal 0.7. V out is the V across the 10 kilo ohm. So V out will equal to 0.7. The output will be something like this. Okay, 0.7 in boost. For the negative part of the signal, or negative part of the sine wave, and negative will connect to the positive, so the diode is open circuit. We will have this circuit only. To get the value of V out, we can first of all apply the KVL. KVL will be negative VI plus ID plus 10 ID. ID will equal VI over 11. To get the value of V out, the current at this branch is ID, which is VI. The current at this branch 2 is the current is V over R, which is V out minus 0 over 10, V out minus 0 over 10. So VI over 11 equal V out minus 0 over 10. The final value of V out will be 10 over 11 multiplied by VI. So the peak here equals to 10 over 11 VI. Okay, that's all for this lecture. I hope using examples, we can conclude that the diode can be used as switch on, switch off. It allows the current to pass since it produces a current that is greater than or equal zero, that is greater than zero. The diode can be used as a limiter since it can produce only exact values that doesn't depend on the input voltage, such as the 0.7. In addition, a resistor diode can be used as in building logic gates. We can explain it in more detail in the coming lectures. We can have one diode in circuit, two diodes in circuit. Diodes can be all of them to be in silicon, some of them to be in germanium. The diodes can be in series, the diodes can be in parallel or combination. The input source can be DC or AC. To solve the question for the DC, we have to solve it using two cases. If the Vn greater than or equal zero, or Vn is less than zero, since the sine wave is alternating in direction, so the diode can be work as positive or on and yeah, forward or reverse in the same circuit. Okay, that's all for this circuit. We hope to meet at the coming lecture.